My name is Ellen Schumer. I'm a fourth generation San Franciscan. In December, this building will be 103 years of age. It is an incredibly rich, rich history. My core responsibility as City Hall historian is to keep the history of this building alive. I am also the docent tour program manager, and I chair the City Hall Advisory Commission. I had two ways of looking at my life. I wanted to be a fashion designer for the movies, and the other one, a political figure, because I had some force from family members. So it was a constant battle between both. I ended up for many years doing the fashion, not for the movies, but for San Franciscans. And then in turn, big changes, and now I'm here. The work that I do at City Hall makes my life broader, richer, more fulfilling than if I was doing something in the garment industry. I have the opportunity to develop relationships with my docents. It's almost like an extended family. I have formed incredible relationships with them and also some of the people that come to take a tour. Lily Lum was this incredible woman. She was a dressmaker of the first order. I would go visit her and it was a special treat. Now, I was a tiny little girl. I would go with my wool coat on and my special little dress because at that period in time, girls did not wear pants. The garment industry at the time that I was in it, and I was a retailer as well as a designer, was not particularly favorable to women. You will see that the predominant designers, owners of huge complexes or huge stores, were all male. Women were sort of relegated to a lesser position. So that you reached a point in it where it was very difficult to survive and survive financially. There was a woman by the name of Diana Vreeland. She was editor of Bazaar and Vogue and went on. And she was a miraculous individual. But she had something that was very unique. She classified it as a third eye. Willie Lewis Brown Jr., who was mayor of San Francisco and was the champion of reopening this building on January 5th of 1999. I believe he has not a third eye, but some kind of antenna attached to his head, because he had the ability to go through this building almost on a daily basis during the restoration and correct everything so that it would appear as it was when it opened in December of 1915.
The Board of Supervisors approved that. I signed it into law. Jeffrey Heller, the City and County of San Francisco owe you and your band of architects a great thing. Just a great thing.
To impart the history of this building is remarkable. To see a person who comes in with sort of a gloomy look on their face, and all of a sudden you start talking about this building, the gloomy look disappears and a smile registers across their face. With children, and I do mainly all of the children's tours, that's a totally different feeling because you're imparting knowledge that they have no idea where it came from, how it was developed, and you can start talking about how things were before we had computer screens, cell phones. Like in 1915, the mayor of San Francisco used to answer the telephone, and he would say, "Good morning, this is Mayor Sonny Jim Rolfe." At times, my clothes make me feel powerful. Powerful in a different sense. I'm not the biggest person in the world, so therefore, I have to have something that would draw your eye to me. And usually, I do that through color, or just the simplicity of the look, or sometimes the complication of the look. I've had people say, "Do those shoes really match that outfit?" You know, retirement to me is a very, very strange word. I don't really ever want to retire because I would like to be able to impart the knowledge that I have, the knowledge that I've learned, and the ongoing honor of working in the People's Palace. If you want a long-term career and you truly want to give something to whatever you do, so long as you know that you are giving to someone or something bigger than yourself, follow your passion and learn how to enrich the feelings along the way.